One of the things we do with Sirius is also we host most of the major concerts in the London Jazz Festival, which is in November. And this year it opens here with a thing called Jazz Voice and a very gifted trumpeter, composer, arranger from London, Guy Barker, puts together a big band with strings, and we get a lot of really good jazz singers from the UK and elsewhere to really start the festival off with something that's kind of a real approachable gala concert, you know, jazz. Last year we had people like Kurt Elling and Sheila Jordan, so American jazz vocal stars, and a lot of UK talent and European talent, a very good singer-songwriter who's a black American woman who's based in France called Crystal Warren. I don't know if you know her. Mm-hmm. She was in the show. So that's an interesting one. And then we've got Sonny Rollins doing an 80th birthday concert, which if it hasn't sold out already, it will very soon. And we've got Chucho Valdez, who draws very well in London, and he's got a new 8-piece band, new record out. And, one of the real giants of jazz piano today, I'd say, with all the Cuban richness to his playing. And another interesting thing we've got coming up is Afro-Cubism, and that is a Cuban-African collaboration. And as you may know, which is the original thing that was supposed to happen in 1996, which became Buena Vista Social Club, what actually happened was the World Circuit Records set up this collaboration in Havana. And I think there was a problem with the musicians from Mali about getting visas. They never turned up. And so with spare studio time, they pulled some old Cuban soneros out of retirement and made that classic record and some others that went on to sell millions, So it's a very happy ending. But this finally now is the project that was supposed to happen 15 years ago. Mm. So there's some really good things. And I think that Brad Meldor is doing something here as well, yeah. Joshua Redman. And I think if you look at that, you get a sense of how broad jazz is. And, that's healthy. I mean, I think we've moved to, it's sad in a way that there aren't any Miles's left, if you like, or Sonny Rollins is perhaps the last one. But I mean, on the other hand, there's a hell of a lot of interesting things happening in areas of jazz, which may be a little sometimes where it relates to other musics. Or I mean, so we had recently had a residency by Wynton Marsalis and the Lincoln Center Jazz Orchestra. And that was great because what they did here was not just a program of concerts. We also had them playing in Victoria Park, Hackney. We did something at Hackney Empire. We did family concerts, talks, masterclasses, the whole thing. Really integrated also into some education work that British musicians were doing. So, and that's a residency thing that's going to come back in a couple of years. But there's an example of a band and a musician who really believe in the tradition. And they get some flack for that. But actually, when you hear that band playing, they do it so well that they justify what they do because they're just doing something at the highest level that can be done.
I think that's...
What's next year? What's happening next year, for example?
Well, it's a funny thing that I don't know because we program, of all the art forms, contemporary music programs, the latest, classical music programs like years ahead and Tejas Theatre. I know that they're sketching in some ideas for next year, but I have to put my hand on my heart and say I'm not sure what they are right now. So I can't give you any juicy tidbits at the moment. But I know it'll be interesting. We'll do another festival of summer festival, which we call Blaze, which again involves a lot of music here, a lot of stuff that's actually happening across East London,
yeah.
And all the boroughs that are involved in the Olympics, those 10 East London boroughs. We're trying to have a role in offering up music for them,
yeah.
And getting into those venues and stuff like that.
So you're very busy the next times.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.